We've received almost $1 million from the Medical Research Future Fund to study and to find a therapy for a rare disease called Hereditary Spastic Paraplegia type 56. And we are super grateful and really excited to get this work started. The wider implications of this research are that once we are able to cure or treat this rare disease, then we might be able to treat other rare diseases using a very similar approach.
So Tallulah Moon was born just as any other child, and she developed normally up until she was 14 months old. And she experienced a really steep regression. For us as parents, we face the dark truth that this is a neurodegenerative disease. And there are other things that come with that over time. But we try not to fixate on that. We focus on the hope and the work that the incredible researchers are doing here at AIBN to find that treatment in time for Tallulah.
Rare diseases are individually rare, but actually very common in the population. It's been estimated about 8% of Australians actually walking around with a rare disease. But because they are rare, it's very hard to develop a therapy for them. So what we're doing by making these organoid models or brain organoid models, we can actually test these therapies at scale and do clinical trials in the dish if you want. An organoid is a mimic of a human organ about the size of a lentil that we can make from stem cells in the dish.
Extremely lucky to have found that Queensland here in our backyard has some of the leading researchers in the world. And that's where our journey into gene therapy and drug repurposing all began.
As soon as Ernst talked to us about the research that they do here at the AIBN and the brain organoid work and what that can mean for helping to find a neurodegenerative disease to test medicines on a mini brain in a dish without affecting our daughter, without risking her life, that for us was like hearing the gods speak to us. And we knew that this is where we wanted to go. This is what we needed to do. So we initiated research immediately with AIBN.
I think the AIBN is perfectly positioned to lead the field of personalized medicine going forward. Because not only do we make organoids from stem cells, but we are also developing technologies to diagnose diseases better and at an earlier stage. And we are developing technologies that allow us to deliver these therapies to the patients. And by combining that within one building and by interacting with the other scientists here, I think this is what drives the future of medicine